Welcome to the Yoga University Presents 21 Hours of You to Become. My name is Manji and I'm going to talk about Kapalbhati, a powerful yogic practice. Kapalbhati, many people think that Kapalbhati is a magic pill and it can cure many diseases and ailments. But yoga is not a mystic, it is a science, it is an empirical science which people of India have been practicing for the well-being, to increase their efficiency for thousands of years. The end of product or the aim or the goal of yoga is samadhi or self-realization. Health is one of the byproducts of yoga. Now, what is health? As per WHO, health is not merely the absence of disease or being physically fit, but it is the state of well-being, physical, mental, emotional, social and spiritual level. So, this holistic approach of yoga is the answer to this kind of well-being. So that is the reason why today the most of the Western world, the developed Western world, is embracing yoga with the open arms. So now let's come back to Kapalbhati. Kapalbhati is a Sanskrit, like made up of two Sanskrit words, Kapal. Kapal means the skull or the forehead, which and the organs inside it, the brain and the brainstem. And Bhati means brightener or illuminator. So, the English name for Kapalbhati is forehead brightener. So, the name itself speaks volumes about the effect of this practice. And now, we see that Kapalbhati is a Shatakarma according to the ancient Indian text. Because it is used for cleansing the frontal lobe of brains, encephalins. And it is also a pranayama as it involves the breathing process. So now we see that most of the pranayamas and the breathing practices, they involve the muscle contractions during the inhalation. Here Kapalbhati reverses this pattern. It is rather active, it has active exhalations and passive inhalation. So it is, you will see that it is initially energizing rather than calming, and it is cleansing and heating rather than cooling. So let us see now what is the effect of this practice on our systems. The you see that during the exhalation there is muscle contraction. So because of this, the respiration, the abdomen and the gastrointestinal receptors are stimulated. The efferent and the efferent centers in the brain are also stimulated, and this directly affects our autonomic nervous system. Now this harmonious synchronizations of all the glands and the organs, it improves the functions of all the systems. Now when all the systems work in harmony with their systems improve, it calms the mind. And when the mind is calm, it uplifts the mind and your productivity is increased by many folds. So this is how it works on our systems. And now, like, what are the benefits? Now, how it is working on our system, you can understand the benefits on its own. First of all, it increases our metabolic rate, which is very effective for weight loss. Then it cleanses the nadis. Nadis are the subtle energy channels, which helps in the free flow of prana in our body. Then it is also it also cleanses our respiratory tract. It stimulates the muscles organs, which is very good for diabetic patients. then it is also improves our circulation, which gives that glow and that radiance on your face, and then it saves the extra expenditure on beauty treatments and the facials, and it is also improves your nervous system, which affects which stimulates and calms the brain cells, and it rejuvenates them, and so the mind becomes calm and uplifted. So these are a few of many benefits of this practice. So now, before going for the demonstration and the techniques, I would like to tell you about the contraindications. Now these people, they should do these practices only after consulting their physician and under the guidance of an expert yoga teacher. So which are these people? Those who have artificial pacemaker or a stent, people who are suffering from hernia or epilepsy, people who have just undergone abdominal surgery, or suffering acute abdominal pain or back pain due to slip disc, and also you should not practice this during the pregnancy. So please consult your doctor and do it under the observation of a yoga expert. So now let's see the demonstration. Namaste. Now I will show you the step-by-step technique of Kapalbhati. Now for that we'll start the session with three omkars and a prayer. So for that, sit in a comfortable position with your back in natural curvature, your hands in Dhyan Mudra, close your eyes. We'll start with three omkars. Take a deep breath. Om. योगेन चित्तस्पदेन वाचा मलं शरीरस्य च वैद्यकेन योपाकरोत्तं प्रवरं मुनिना पतञ्जलिं प्राञ्जलिरां तोस्मे पतञ्जलिं प्राञ्जलिरां तोस्मे. Keep your eyes closed and feel the vibrations of Omkar and the effect of prayer on your mind and body. Scan your body from the toes to your head region. Relax your muscles, relax your joints, and make your mind ready for the session of Kapalbhati. With a beautiful smile on your lips, gently open your eyes. Now I will show you the sitting. First we will see the sitting technique of Kapalbhati. Kapalbhati sitting is like in a comfortable position. Whatever you're comfortable in, you can sit in a cross-legged Sukhasana, or you can sit in Padmasana or Ardha Padmasana, or you can also sit on a chair and practice. Only condition is that your back should be in erect in natural, the spine should be in natural curvature, your shoulder should be a bit back, your chest open so that you can breathe freely, your hands in Drona Mudra on your knees, and your chin parallel to the ground and eyes closed. So this is the starting position for Kapalbhati. After this we have to inhale forcefully and fix our chest and shoulders. So inhale and fix your chest and shoulders up. Keeping your chest, your shoulders up only, relax your abdomen and start giving the stroke.
your abdomen, take your shoulders down, your chest down, keep your eyes closed, observe the effect of Kapalbhati on your mind, your body, focus on your breath. So this is how you can, this is the correct technique of practicing. I'll do one more round and I'll show you. You can keep your hand on your abdomen to feel the movement of your abdomen. So we'll do it once again. Take a deep breath, inhale and fix your shoulders and your chest up. Then relax your abdomen. You can keep your hand on your abdomen and start the strokes. Relax your abdomen. Take your shoulders down, your chest down. Keep your eyes closed and observe the effect of the practice on your mind, on your body. Focus on your breath. So now I will show you some mistakes that people usually do while practicing. So one is that they forcefully contract their nose and, you know, close their eyes tightly. So I'll show you how they do that. So this is not, you don't require, your facial expression should be absolutely smooth. And then the other mistake that people do is they make a very harsh voice from their throat. So this is also absolutely wrong. And the third mistake that they do is when they are doing exhalations, their chest and shoulders keep moving down. So it is like, once you fix your chest and shoulders up, so this is wrong, your chest and shoulders are fixed up only throughout the practice, and when you complete one round, then only you relax your abdomen and then take your chest and your shoulders down. I will do one more round of the practice correctly. So inhale, fix your chest and shoulders up. Your abdomen relax and then start the strokes. Take your shoulders down, your chest down, relax your abdomen. Keep your eyes closed and observe the effect. You should not immediately open your eyes, you should observe the effect that it has on your mind and body. And then gently open your eyes. So friends, I hope you all understood the correct way of doing Kapalbhati, and I am sure that you will include this wonderful practice, which is very powerful, in your daily yoga abhyas. And with best wishes for you all, be healthy and always be happy. Namaskar.